If you're a parent and you don't know where your kid is, time is not your friend. It gets worse.
Heavy words from local missing persons and human trafficking consultant Dottie Laster, who has been following Lena's case. The discontinued Amber Alert for missing 3-year-old Lena Kill concerns Laster, though she says police have been extensive in their search for her.
It's the first sign that law enforcement resources are starting to pull back, and that's very scary and sad for all that care about her.
We reached out to SAPD to see what the discontinued Amber Alert means. We were sent a statement. It says in part, quote, "We want to once again reassure the family of Lena Kill and the community that our investigation and search for Lena has not stopped. We will continue to diligently continue combing through leads in hopes of locating Lena and returning her with her family." The missing persons case involving Lena is in active investigation. This is the playground where Lena was last seen. You can see over here a few flowers and a stuffed unicorn has been left here. Just a few days ago, the police and some other federal agencies wrapped a search for her just a couple of miles down from the apartments where she lives. So far, the community and the Islamic Center of San Antonio don't plan to stop their efforts to bring Lena home. The center will keep the reward money they've raised in place.
The $100,000 will remain there, as far as I know, until the near future, because we want some information. And we realize that that may be an incentive for somebody.
Everyone praying and hoping for her safe return.
I hope she's found. If someone has her, I would say we will never stop looking for her. Years, decades, I hope it doesn't go that far. But this community doesn't stop.
Tonight, San Antonio is closing in on a number few thought possible at the start of the COVID-19 pandemic. Rudy Arispe with Metro Health calling it a true tragedy.
The fact is San Antonio is nearing 5,000 deaths because of COVID. This is a true tragedy.
It's hit home for many in San Antonio, including District 4 Councilwoman Dr. Adriana Rocha Garcia. In 2020, she lost 7 family members to the virus. And now others are fighting against it.
I have 2 uncles right now in Mexico that are struggling through COVID, and I have several cousins that are still going through it. And so one of my uncles is in the hospital right now, and they're trying to get fluid out of his lungs.
Dr. Rocha Garcia is working to help her district financially with utilities and to have access to testing as well as vaccines, adding it's not always possible for some to travel long distances.
Our families, they work sometimes double, you know, 2 jobs. Some even work 3 jobs. We know that they live in multi-generational families.
Zip code 78245 within District 4 has seen 161 deaths so far. Another district hit hard is District 1, with zip code 78207 currently reporting 272 deaths. Councilman Mario Bravo says he is working to help his residents.
We have reached out to Metro Health and told them we want to work with them to organize pop-up clinics in some of the low-income zip codes here in District 1.
The lines are actually a little bit shorter than what we saw last week at other COVID testing sites when they first opened up, and I think the weather probably has a big factor to do with that. It's pretty cold and chilly out there, but even with that, more than 500 people have been tested for COVID-19 here at St. Philip's College alone today. Now, for the folks that showed up and were waiting outside, once again, it was pretty cold and windy. I saw a lot of people bundled up in those blankets. But the good news is they were not waiting outside very long. The line did move very quickly. Here at St. Philip's College, there are 7 technicians set up to run the free COVID testing site here, so that things go by pretty quickly. A massive snowstorm on the northeast side, in the northeast of this country, created some supply delays for community labs over the weekend, which was slowing down how quickly people were able to get their results. I've been told that they got their shipment of supplies on hand, and people should be getting their COVID-19 test results in about 24 hours, which is good news for anyone who is anxious to get an answer.
Over at the store that I work, there's like several cases going on, so I just want to just make sure that I'm fine. So.
Now, a lot of the people that I've talked to today showed up to get a COVID test for their kid after their child was potentially exposed to someone with COVID-19 in the classroom. Others told me that they were getting tested to make sure they were clear to go back to work. Now, if you're on the east side and you'd like to get a COVID test today, come over to St. Philip's College anytime between 8 o'clock to 6 p.m. today. The testing location is over on the South Walter Street side, so that's the area where you would need to park as well.
It's election year, San Antonio. Community leaders want to make sure everyone has the opportunity. opportunity to vote. Fox San Antonio's Amanda Henderson explains how one group is working to help communities impacted by mass incarceration.
Bringing in the new year with a very important message.
With some elections months away, these community advocates want you to make your voice heard.
Today is about organizing our voting rights and our voting power.
Power Steve Huerta with All of Us or None Texas hopes those formerly incarcerated will also use. That's the message behind today's gathering.
We don't tell people who to vote for, but we inform them about who's running and what their principles are, and we let them make that decision. We have to start taking up the responsibility of being more civically engaged.
In Texas, you can regain your right to vote after finishing your sentence, which includes parole and or probation. Huerta, as well as everyone we spoke with for today's story, was formerly incarcerated. As Benny Price and Leorna Walker explain, being able to help people in this situation is something they value.
And this is a country that will give you a second chance. The greatest country in the world will give its heavily populated, formerly incarcerated population a second chance.
So many of us that have been through incarceration don't have the education and knowledge about voting and our voting rights and what it does to help our people get the resources and education and have the platform to speak.
A platform Chevas Watson says they hope everyone realizes they can use to help make change happen.
Like, people evolve, the city evolves, the climate of voting evolves, you know. So if anything, to all that are formerly incarcerated here in Bexar County, stand up, get involved,